guys, how are you guys doing? And today I do you guys this kind of look for Valentine's Day. So like a champagne with the like half cup crease glitter and a little bit of like a rosy pink lips. My version kind of Valentine's Day. I hope you guys have fun with this video. And if you guys would like to see how I get this look, and please keep on watching. So, how'd you guys like my new background? I have the new lights set up. I have a new backdrop that I got from the other day. And yeah, they're pretty cool. They make my video a lot more better, I guess, better quality. Okay, so I already put my skincare on, some little moisturizer. And then today we're gonna start from the eyes makeup first, cause I don't want any fallouts on my face. So let's jump into it. So to start first, I'm going to prime my lid with my 24-hour extend eyes base from MAC. I'm going to prime my lid with this one. So make sure you blend them good, or if you like my eyebrow today, it's just way so long. But that's okay. So next, I'm gonna screw my...
Oh. I'm just gonna scoot my mirror to the side a little bit because I need to see myself.
Okay, so after you finish priming, priming your eyelid, we're gonna set them with a little bit of powder. So I'm just gonna use any powder will work, translucent powder or even any eyeshadow. I'm gonna use my Sigma Taper Highlighting Brush. I like to use them as my powder brush. So I'm gonna set it on my eyelids where I apply my primer. So first, I'm gonna be going in with my color range Queen of Hearts. So this palette, it's really nice and good palette for my opinion, because I really love this one so much. They have warm tones, and they have like a little purples, they have a little like a metallic color, which is really pigmented. I love them so much. So I use them a lot, as you can see. So first I'm gonna be using this one right here, this color. And for my brush, I'm gonna be using my Sigma Taper Blending Brush E14. This one is just like a nice little blending brush like this. It's really pigmented, so make sure you always tap them first. So I like to drag my color out to the side a little bit, like that.
Maybe I should zoom you guys a little bit more closer? What do you think? Okay, that's better.
So please don't mind my hair. I woke up and I took shower, I eat. And today's my day off, that's why I try to, make some video for you guys. So this one's good. I'm slowly gathering, blending this.
It's so hard for me doing makeup and not turn on the AC. Because if I turn on the AC, you guys won't be able to hear my voice at all. So just kind of... sacrifice myself here, and hopefully I don't get sweat.
Then we're gonna go a little bit of my mix, this two color to mix them. I'm sorry, this color and that color. Tap it out. It's like we know they're really pigmented. So I'm just gonna get the other corner a little bit more darker.
Today I want to do the Thai version, but because my boyfriend keep complaining like, oh, you want me to watch your video, but you speak Thai, how am I supposed to understand what you're talking about? So I was like, maybe I should do like two versions, the English version and the Thai version. What do you guys think? Because so that all my Thai friends and also my friends over here can understand what I'm talking about or what I'm trying to explain.
So you basically kind of dark it up the outer corner like this. And don't drag it too much in the front. Just kind of focus the products over here, and then you slowly blend across to your inner corner. Not too much, because we don't want it to be really hard on this look. So after, when you finish with your this one, then next color, I wanted to deepen up a little bit by using my, this one is my Resort Professional Makeup Palette. That's okay. This is like really neutral palette. I'm gonna use this brown right here. So I'm going to change my brush to the one that's smaller and more defined. I'm gonna be using my MAC 221. Oh my god, I almost chopped it off. Like that. So tiny, it's nice and dirty. So I'm gonna use this dark brown color for my Resort Professional Makeup Eyeshadow. I'm gonna be using one with the MAC 221 blending brush. So after you finish blending your outer corner, so this is what you should get, this kind of color. I'm going to use my concealer from NYX HD. This is NYX HD Studio in the shade CW04. And I'm going to be using with my MAC 212, I believe. So I'm gonna put a little amount of my hand. It's just like almost like a half cut crease. It's like, that's what I can't explain. Maybe I should zoom you guys a little bit more closer. Right there. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna cover up right here, but because I have a hooded eyes, so I'm gonna cover a little bit more higher. So even though when I open my eyes, you guys will still be able to see my eyeshadow color. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put it right here and look up like that to get the color, so that way I know where I should kind of like carve them. So I'm gonna start doing that. So that's kind of what it looks like when I look up a little bit. When I kind of look this way, then I'm gonna make them a little bit more even. I'm just gonna use my finger to just kind of like tap them a little bit so that they don't get too sticky on your lid. So I'm gonna blend the edges at the back too as well. So that kind of what it's supposed to look like that. You can crop them a little bit more. I would like to crop them a little bit more larger. So I'm gonna go back at the top and just gonna start to crop them. So I'm gonna do the same thing as my other side. After you finish cut your lid, this is what you should kinda get. So this is like a half cut crease, just like that. Then you're gonna set them with a little bit of the light eyeshadow. I'm just gonna use this palette. I'm just gonna use that white right there. Then next I'm going to be using my MAC Mixing Medium Base. Only just a tiny bit. I'm gonna use my Legoland flat brush that I use to set my eyeshadow. This one, it's MAC 242. And I'm gonna use this one as my base for my next eyeshadow that I'm going to put. I'm gonna do this. Just apply. Don't make them too wet. Okay. Then you kind of want to wait until it's a little bit almost dry, and then you start to put your next shadow. And this one also helps your eyeshadow look more intense color. The color pay off more pigmented.
Do side by side. Don't do both sides at the same time.
I'm gonna use my Naked palette. This one is called Shopper. I'm gonna pack the color. Oh, it's like a nice kind of pink. You're gonna wait it until it's consider to just cover everything. Make sure it's all clean, it's all cut. So when you get this, you're gonna go back with your smaller blending brush. But I'm gonna go back with the first color and this one to mix and to blend the edges right there. I'm gonna make them a little bit more smooth. Next, we're going to use my glitter liner, NYX Liquid Crystal Liner. So you're gonna draw the glitter above your fake crease. Little dimension. And we're gonna go over with other side, same thing, repeat the same step. Okay, so I'm done with that. So this is what you should get. It's like a silver glitter and a little bit of pink champagne on your lids and a little bit of smoky in the outer corner. I'm gonna wait until this dry a little bit.
Because I cannot do my eyeliner in the camera, so I'm gonna do it off the camera and I will be right back.
So after I finish with my wing eyeliner, but I'm gonna be finishing up my eyes with some fall lashes. Today I'm gonna be using my Kiss lashes. So I like just put a little put like the extra on my lid, the glue. Just kinda draw them almost like a wing liner.
Okay, now after pop up some lash on, I feel a little bit more if you will, okay?
Milani Make It Last Setting Spray Prime Collect and Set. I showed this to you guys at my drugstore haul. I'm gonna use this one too as a primer. It smelled so good. Alright, so I'm back with my beauty blender. After I finish priming my face, I'm gonna go with my foundation. This one is NARS Sheer Glow in a medium 3. And this one, it's my Makeup Forever brush. It's like a color that you mix in with your foundation. It's like a yellow color. And I mix these two together. And then I put them in my L'Oreal True Matte Lumi Cushion. It will be more easy for me in the morning because I don't like mixing every morning and get like all over my my back of my hand. And this is like my holy grail foundation. This is my second bottle. How different this side and that side. I'm gonna be using contour, cream contour. This one is from MAC in the shade 8.5. It's like a nice little warm contour shade. I'm gonna be using this with my stippling brush. I'm just gonna go like this. Oh my god, I'm getting sweaty. Maybe I need to be, I need to turn on the AC. Yeah, I'm really sorry. You might won't be able to hear my voice as good as earlier, but I'll try to talk louder so you guys can hear my voice. Because I feel like I'm getting sweating and then my makeup's gonna come off before I even finish doing makeup look. And as you can see, this side might not look as good as this side because I have an even skin tone. So every time I try to do my contour, it's like a really, like a lot of work. I need to go with like a really full coverage foundation for me to get like a nice contour, but I'm not looking for that today. So that's why I just throw it out there in case if some of you guys could be like, oh, look at her contour, so perfect, it looks So just throw it out there first, you know. So I'm gonna use my Sephora Bright Future in the color yellow 02. It's like a color correcting, but I like to use them as my concealer because I love being a nice yellow shade and brighten under eyes as my concealer.
This concealer is really nice because it's really easy to blend and it's really good coverage. It's not full coverage. If you guys are looking for like a full coverage kind of like concealer, this might not be the one for you. This is just like an everyday type of concealer.
This just looks so terrifying. Alright, let's start blending. I'm gonna go back a little bit of our MAC contour color. Maybe a little bit more bronze. Now we're ready for our powder. So today powder, I'm gonna be using my Midnight Banana powder. Just like that. I'll put it in my hands and just use my Damn Beauty blender. I'm gonna bake my under my contour. The thing that I like to do, I don't like to leave my under eye. I don't like to leave my baking powder, my under eye, too long because I have a really dry under eye. And for my nose contour, I like to use my this kind of brush. This one's also from Sigma Medium Angle Shader E70. So it's like that kind of brush. My camera, I just turn it off and I just turn it back on, and I also do some little my nose contour, and I'm about to dust off the powder right now. And then I also finish my contour for both sides. I'm gonna be dust off some of the powder. Really lightly dust off. After we finish with this one, we're gonna go with some blush. And the blush color that I'm going to use today from Wet n Wild Color Icon. This one's like a night pink color. Sigma Large Angle Contour F40. I like to use this kind of brush for my blush. So I'm gonna go with that. Ooh, it's a lot of fallout. Just gotta tap it out a little bit. Oh, really pigmented. After you finish doing your blush, I like to go back in with my, to finish my lower lash. repeat all the same color from the lighter to the darker and smoke it out. And I'm gonna be using my Sigma Tepa Blender E35. It's like a little small, nice blending brush. And to get really close to my my lash line, I like to use this kind of brush to blend my dark color. And I'm gonna use my this one for my bottom lashes, which I love so much. This is the only mascara that I use for my bottom lashes, and it doesn't smash down on my like my under eyes around here. So I like to just kind of do this, see that kind of shape, because it get like really easy get to your bottom lash and lips. Going to go back with the Milani Make It Last setting spray. I'm gonna use this one. I'm gonna go with my Lolicular Big Glitter. I'm gonna use the Gillette Honey, which is that one in the middle. I'm gonna use my Smashbox fan brush. I'm gonna go hand with this thing because you know how your girl love highlight. It's like a nice and wet looking kind of texture. I'm gonna highlight my cupid's bow. Okay. And lastly step, we're going to go on my lip, and that combo I'm gonna be using all my drugstore. And for the liner, I'm gonna go in with my Milani Color Statement Lip Liner in the color Spice. I'm gonna go with my Sweet Cream Matte from Liquid Lips Color from Jordana in the shade Tiramisu. I told you guys how I love this so much on my drugstore makeup. Okay guys, so this is it with my makeup look. I know I didn't do my hair, I just let them down, just like kind of use my hair to comb them a little bit. But yeah, this is it. I hope you guys liked it. It's just like a little soft glam, like my kind of soft version makeup for Valentine's Day. I'll see you guys next time in my next video. And before you leave, please don't forget to subscribe and give this video a big thumbs up. Comment down below if next time you guys would like to see any looks, any requests from me. I will try to go through every comment for you guys and answer. And alright, I hope you guys have a good day. And then thank you for watching. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye.